Hi, I'm Rebecca. In this video, you will learn all about how to draw something custom in Compose. Custom drawing is useful for when the built-in components just don't cover exactly what your app needs. Say you have a custom graph that you want to draw, or you want to create a fun flashlight effect in your app, or even a complex shader background. It's all possible in Compose. To get started with drawing in Compose, we can use a drawing modifier, such as Modifier DrawBehind. This modifier allows us to draw content behind our Composable's content. For example, if we wanted to draw a simple circle, we can call DrawCircle inside DrawBehind. This results in a circle that takes up the full size of the Composable. It's worth noting that inside the DrawBehind modifier, we are in a DrawScope. So what is DrawScope? DrawScope is a declarative stateless drawing API to draw shapes, paths, etc. without needing to maintain your own state. If you look at the interface definition of DrawScope, you will see it has a bunch of methods used for drawing, such as drawLine, drawRect, etc. We can also get access to the size and center of the drawing area. These will be useful when trying to adjust the sizing and placement of an item. If we wanted a simple drawing, we could use the Canvas Composable. However, looking under the hood, we can see that this is just a convenient wrapper around Modifier DrawBehind. So there are several drawing modifiers that also give you access to a DrawScope, allowing you to draw with other Composables. The different modifiers are DrawBehind, which allows you to draw content behind the content of the Composable, DrawWithContent, which allows you to choose when to call the content of your Composable. This is useful for when you want to rearrange when content is drawn, for instance, in front or behind the drawing code. And draw with cache, which caches the objects until the size changes or the state variables read inside change. Each of these are very useful in their own regard, but for now, we will stick with using Canvas, since our drawings are quite simple at the moment. Right, so we have our circle that we've drawn, but we want to position it differently from where it is placed right now. All of the drawing functions on DrawScope have default values set for the size and position of the drawing commands. These can be easily overridden when we need to change them. But to know how to set the size and position, we need to understand a bit more about the coordinate system used in Compose. The coordinate system used in Compose is the same as the view system. It has the 0,0 point in the top left corner of the Composable. And the bottom right has the coordinates of width and height. The Y value increases as it moves downward, and the X value increases as it moves to the right. We also need to keep in mind that all draw and layout calls are performed in pixel values, not DP. Therefore, to draw things consistently across screens, you should use DP and convert to pixels before drawing. Draw calls are also always relative to the parent Composable. If you're placed inside a box that has a certain height and offset, your coordinate system changes to be relative to the parent. The 0,0 point is now at that offset, and the width and height of the drawing area is now the size of the parent Composable. Back to our circle. So to change the position of the circle we have drawn on screen, we can set the center point of the circle to have a different offset, say 20 dp in the x direction and 100 dp in the y direction. We can also change the radius of the circle to only take up 60 dp, instead of the default of taking up the full size of the drawing area. Great, we have a circle that we now know how to size and position. Let's look at what other transformation functions are available to us. DrawScope offers a few different transformations that can be applied to the drawing commands. For example, if we wanted to scale up everything that is drawn on our canvas, we can use DrawScope scale function with an X and Y value for how many times the item should be scaled. In this case, we're drawing a small circle with a 20 dp radius, but we're scaling it 10 times horizontally and 15 times vertically. So it ends up as an oval with 200 dp width and 300 dp height. And to translate all the contents, we can call translate with a left and top offset that'll be applied to all the content drawn inside. To apply rotation to content, you can call rotate with the amount of degrees to rotate the drawn content. Another transformation is to perform an inset to everything that is being drawn inside, providing a horizontal and vertical pixel amount that will effectively pad the lambda content. If you want to apply multiple transformations to your content, use the with transform function that applies transformations to the content, such as translate, etc. Now you understand the basics of drawing something in Compose, let's build something a little bit more practical, like this shiny line graph. So first, let's start drawing the background of the graph. We can see it has a number of vertical and horizontal lines. The first step is we set the background to our purple background color, and then create a canvas with a 3:2 aspect ratio to keep it in the correct size. Then we can draw the outline rectangle for the whole graph using a white color and a stroke. This will take up the whole canvas area size. Next up, we repeatedly call drawLine for each vertical line in the graph that we want to draw, offsetting it by an equal amount each time. We repeat the same things for horizontal lines, calling repeat for each line that'll be drawn horizontally, with a different start Y value each time. Now we have the background drawn for our graph, we can go about drawing the actual line that represents the data. So we had the canvas composable that we were using, but now we are going to need to create a path object and draw the line of the graph. We don't want to be recreating this path object on every recomposition, so to avoid that, we can switch to using the drawWithCache modifier, which will take care of caching the objects until the size of the drawing area changes. It's worth noting that you should only use this if you are creating objects in the draw functions. Otherwise, it'll create unnecessary lambdas. Next, we create a path object. We can call our function generatePath that takes the graph data into it, as well as the size of the area that we are drawing into. We will look at the definition of this function in a second, but let's assume that we have this path object already. To actually draw the path, we now call drawPath with the path, the color, and the stroke width that we want the line to have. We get a nice green line drawn. But how is the actual path generated? Looking at our generatePath function, it goes along the following lines. It creates a path, and for each data point in that list of points, it adds a call to path.lineTo to the path that we are generating. And then it returns this path. Great, let's move on to the next step. Now to get the area below the graph filled with the green gradient, we can create another path, where we add the original path and then create a closed area to fill in. So to create this closed area, we need to add two more lines, a line to the bottom right of the graph, and then another line to the bottom left of the graph, where we started. We then call close to close the path. Then we call drawPath with the green gradient brush that we've made. Our graph looks great as it is, but it would look way nicer if the lines were smooth between the values. So let's smooth the lines using path functions. To do the smoothing, all we need to do is change our generatePath function to generate a path with curves in it. We calculate our two control points for each point that we want to add to our lines. And instead of calling lineTo, we call cubicTo using these two control points, giving us a smoother line and a better looking graph overall. And as a bonus, because what's a composed video without a small animation, let's look at how we can animate the line that is drawn on launch of the graph. First, let's create an animatable object that we will remember. We then call animateTo in our launched effect, so that this will only run once on the launch of our composable. We now have a value that'll animate from 0 to 1. Now, to use this value, we can clip out paths that are drawing on screen using this animation value that we created. We use the clipRect method that will clip all the draw calls that are inside that lambda. We set the right edge of the rectangle to be a fraction of the width. And because this animation progress value animates from 0 to 1, we will get a reveal animation happening over time. Running this, we can see the graph area is now drawn over time, creating the reveal animation effect. And that's it for this video. Take a look at the Compose graphics docs to learn more about drawing in Compose. Happy composing!